गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू क्लास 10 बायोलॉजी लेसन नंबर 18. इन आ प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड व्हाट ट्रांसपिरेशन इज एंड द डिफरेंट मेथड्स बाय विच इट कैन बी मेजर्ड. वी ऑल्सो नो दैट मैक्सिमम वाटर इज लॉस्ट फ्रॉम द लीव्स ऑफ द प्लांट्स बाय अ प्रोसेस विच इज़ नोन एज टोमैटल ट्रांसपिरेशन. द क्वेश्चन अराइजेज, व्हाट इज दिस टोमैटा? Stomata are minute pores surrounded by two specialized cells called guard cells. They are present in the epidermis of leaves and young stems. Guard cells are kidney shaped in dicot leaves and dumbbell shaped in monocot leaves. The shape is different, but function of both of them is same. Guard cells have walls which are differentially thickened. That is to say that the thickening all around is not same. It is more towards the inner side than towards the outer side. Where the thickening is more, it is inelastic, and where the thickening is less, it is more elastic. That is to say that if water enters the guard cells, it pushes more to the elastic side, thus bringing about opening of the stomata. With this in our mind, let us see which part of the dorsiventral leaf has more stomata and more transpiration takes place from that area. Mechanism of stomatal transpiration. Water absorbed by the roots reach the leaves via the xylem vessels of the roots and stems. In the leaves are present the spongy cells surrounded by intercellular spaces. Look at the figure. There are two types of cells present. The one which are on the upper side are called the palisade cells, and they are more compactly arranged and they have more amount of chlorophyll in them. Whereas the lower one are spongy cells because there are large intercellular spaces between them and they have less amount of chlorophyll in them. There are more stomata that you see on the lower side than you can see on the upper side. The turgidity of the mesophyll cells is maintained by the diffusion of water from the xylem vessels of the leaves. The dark structures that you see, they are the xylem vessels. Water from these cells keep on evaporating from their exposed walls. When the air inside the intercellular spaces gets saturated, it moves out through the open stomata. The cell walls, which are losing water due to transpiration, replace them by drawing more water from the adjoining cells by a process called imbibition, that is, movement of water through the walls, cell walls. Thousands of cells in the leaves lose water, causing a pulling action, a suction that is created through the xylem vessels. This is called the transpirational pull. The pull is so strong that it can pull water up to 50 meters in tall trees. Experiment 1. In this experiment, we will demonstrate that more transpiration takes place from the lower side of the dorsiventral leaf as compared to the upper side. For this, what do? We take a well-watered plant and put a strip of cobalt chloride on the upper and lower surface and clamp it as shown in the figure. What do we observe after some time? The cobalt chloride strip on the lower side turns pink faster than the strip fixed on the upper side. Inference: since the strip on the lower side becomes pink fast, this means that water lost by the lower side is more than the upper surface of the leaf. Now, this is another very important experiment, also known as the four-leaf experiment. Aim is to demonstrate that leaf surface, upper and lower, in a dorsiventral leaf transpires more. Which surface? The lower surface or the upper surface? And do both of them transpire? Now, for this, what do? We take four leaves of almost same size and weigh all of them in the beginning of the experiment. In the first one, that is A, we put Vaseline on the upper and lower surface and even the stalk of the leaf. In the second one, that is the B leaf, we apply Vaseline on the lower surface. In the third one, that is C, we apply Vaseline on the upper surface together with the stalk. Stalk we'll apply in all of them. And in the last one, we do not apply Vaseline at all. We leave these four leaves for a period of time and then observe them. What do you observe? Loss of weight in leaf A is negligible and it is least shriveled. Loss of weight in leaf B is more than A but less than C and D. It is also less shriveled than C and D. Loss of weight in leaf C is more than A and B but less than D. It is also less shriveled than D. Loss of weight is maximum in leaf D and it is the most shriveled. What is the inference of this experiment? Both the surfaces of the leaves transpire. That is, transpiration takes place from the upper surface also and lower surface also. That is why loss of weight in leaf D is maximum, because both the surfaces are exposed. Rate of transpiration from the lower surface is more is proved by the fact that loss of weight in C is more than that of leaf B. This is because leaf C, the upper surface is greased with Vaseline and the lower surface is exposed for transpiration. Whereas in leaf B, the lower surface is covered with Vaseline, hence transpiration takes place from the upper surface. Last of all, loss of weight of leaf A is negligible because all parts are covered with Vaseline that checks transpiration. It is clear that both surfaces of the leaves transpire, but transpiration takes place more from the lower surface as compared to the upper surface. Now, let us see the factors that affect transpiration. There are two types of factors, internal factors also and external factors also. Internal factors. Leaf area. Larger the surface area, more would be the transpiration. You see those two leaves? If the leaf is small, that means number of stomata would be less, hence transpiration would be less. Whereas if the leaf is big, transpiration would be more because number of stomata would be more in them. Leaf structure. Even the structure matters. Presence of thick cuticle. If the cuticle is thick, transpiration would be less. Sunken stomata, as shown in the figure, transpiration is comparatively less. More transpiration takes place with less water contents in the leaf. When it all depends how much water is present in the leaf. There is more water in the leaf, more transpiration will take place. But if there is less water in the leaves will wilt and it will reduce transpiration. Succulents, presence of latex or mucilage is in the tissue of stem and leaves reduces the rate of transpiration. That is the reason why xerophytic plants have succulents. External factors. Light plays a very important factor in transpiration. In the presence of light, the stomata open. Light also increases temperature of the leaf, which in turn increases transpiration. Temperature. An increase in temperature up to a certain limit increases the rate of transpiration. Very low or very high temperature causes closure of stomata, hence decline in transpiration. Humidity of the atmosphere. The rate of transpiration decreases with the rise of water vapor in the atmosphere and increases with its fall. More the humidity, less would be the transpiration. Carbon dioxide. Increase in carbon dioxide contents more than normal, that is more than 0.3%, causes closure of stomata, hence transpiration decreases. Wind, very important factor in transpiration. When the leaves are exposed to wind, which is moderate, the water vapor does not accumulate in the vicinity of the leaves. This leads to increase in the rate of transpiration. But winds of high velocity causes closure of stomata, which leads to decrease in the rate of transpiration. Atmospheric pressure. As the atmospheric pressure decreases, density of air also decreases. This leads to rapid diffusion of water vapor. Hence, increase in the rate of transpiration. Soil water. A decrease in water uptake by plants causes complete or partial closure of stomata. This leads to decrease in transpiration. So these are the external factors responsible for transpiration. Now let us prove this with the help of a simple experiment. You can see in the figure that is the Genong's potometer, which you have already studied in the previous class. Please set it up as shown in the figure. Aim: to demonstrate the effect of external factors on transpiration. Procedure: set up the experiment as shown in the figure. Place the apparatus for a few hours in different environmental conditions, such as there are four conditions in which we are going to check it out: in direct sunlight, in a warm room with still air, in a warm room in front of a fan, and in an air-conditioned room. These are the four aspects we are going to study. Observation: in direct sunlight, the air bubble moves at a fast rate because stomata are open and temperature is high. This leads to rapid transpiration. Transpiration is high when the apparatus is kept in the warm room because the temperature is high there. Transpiration is highest when it is kept in a warm room with a fan. Usually in the exam this comes. It is lowest when the apparatus is placed in an air-conditioned room. What is the inference? The rate of transpiration increases with sunlight, temperature, and wind velocity. With this, we come to an end of this lesson. Thank you. Take care, and God bless you all.